Hello and welcome to Method CRM User Tutorials. My name is Errol and today we are continuing our series on Report Designer. In this video, we're going to introduce you to pivot grids. And here's one now, and I can imagine your response. Errol, that's a spreadsheet. And you're right, that's all it is. But all this information was automatically populated without me doing anything, except for setting up parameters and making it stylish. And look how useful it is. It shows the invoice amounts organized by month and by customer. Furthermore, it shows grand totals. All the math was done for me automatically. Now, before we make this fantastic grid of amazing, you need three things. One, data. See all the amounts in here? That's the data we wish to display. Two, columns. In the columns, we put in the transaction dates. Three, rows. And in here, we list the customers. And those are the ingredients you need to make a pivot grid. Got that? Rows, columns, and data. You may want to make other pivot grids that don't show invoice amounts, but you will always need to keep in mind rows, column, and data, okay? Let's get started. I will make a brand new report. The master table is the invoice table, and I'll just call it pivot grid fun. To begin with, I'll just add in a report header, minimize everything else, and then I'll also make this report landscape. Under controls, you will see pivot grid, and you should drag that into your report header. Note, do not drag your pivot grid into the detail band. That only leads to weeping and madness, so don't go there. Anyway, let me just make the pivot grid bigger, and now let me hit the arrow to get to the pivot grid tasks. First, you need to set the data source. I will set it to dataset 1, and that automatically sets our data member to the master table of invoice. Awesome sauce. Next, let's hit run designer, and whoa, look at all this. This may be daunting, but remember, stay focused. We want to add the fields we wish to display in our pivot grid. If you click the double arrows here, you will see all the fields we can add, and they're crumbs, 124 fields to choose from. I only want three fields though, remember? Those magic three things, row, columns, data. And as you can see from our example chart, the first is the amount, I'll double click it, then the customer, and finally the transaction date. That's it, that's all I need for now. I want to assign those fields to row, column, data. I'm just gonna close that field list because it's intimidating. And now, if I click on each field, I can change their properties. First, let's set amount to data. Here in behavior, you will see area. That's where I will set to row, column, or data. In this one, for amount, I want to set it to data area. Cool, let's go set the customer field. It too has behavior, and in area, I will select row area. And finally, we will change the transaction date to column area. Actually, it's defaulted to column area, so all good. Great, let's close this window and see what it looks like. Preview, ha! We have a pivot grid that spans many pages and is difficult to read. But all the data is there, trust me. So let's make it a bit more readable. Let's go back into the pivot grid property editor. And if you recall, it showed the invoice amounts for every day. I really want to summarize it by month, and this can be done automatically. Haha. So let's click the transaction date field, and under behavior, you will find the grouping interval. And look, I can group the dates by a number of things, month, quarter, year, solstice, anything. So I'm gonna choose month. And now when I close and preview this, ha, nice! It has summed each column up by month, but it still spans two pages. Okay, let me change one more thing. I just wanna make a quick change. So I'm going to select the transaction date here in the pivot grid. And look, I can change the properties over here. I don't have to go into the property grid editor. Make sure that you select the transaction date field though. If you select anything else, you'll change the properties for whatever you select, and then you'll be upset that nothing's changed and you'll blame me. And we don't want that. I sure don't want that. Anyway, just scroll down until we find layout. Here I can change the width of the columns and I will change it to 70. Now preview. Ha! Look, it's our pivot grid, and it looks fine, and it automatically calculates so many things. Do you remember from previous videos I had to set up the formatting and filters so it didn't show zero amount balances? I didn't have to do that here. It's like a magic grid of awesome! And that's it. That's it for this tutorial. Join us in our next video where we delve a little bit more into pivot grids. It gets pretty exciting. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the YouTube comments, check our documentation both on our forums, or you can tweet us at MethodCRM. Thanks for watching, and have a great day. Bye-bye!